invite our last speaker of this session, Ms. Tine Onert from Denmark. Unfortunately, I did not have any specifics, so I would like to ask you, to ask you to say a few words on your background.
This is
you. Yeah. Okay, so even that's incorrect.
Just to keep the record safe, my name is not Tine, it's Dorte Jørgensen.
Yeah. Please go ahead.
Well, thank you for joining this presentation. And as I said, my name is Dorte Jørgensen, and I'm from Køer in Denmark, which is a part of the Veolia Water Solution Group. Today I would like to talk about advanced process control by STAR Control and show an example of how STAR has performed and has been giving results of the nitrogen outlet. I will start my presentation by going through the agenda of today's presentation. First of all, I would like to tell you about the case story of Ede wastewater treatment plant, and then tell you why advanced process control could be a good idea at Ede wastewater treatment plant. Then I will move on to a description of STAR control and tell you about STAR at Ede wastewater treatment plant. Finally, I will end this presentation by concluding the effects of the implementation of STAR at Ede wastewater treatment plant. Ede wastewater treatment plant is a plant located in central Netherlands, just 1 hour from here. The plant is operated by Dutch Waterschap Vallei & M. Sorry if my pronouncement is not okay. And the plant is designed for 300,000 person equivalent. The plant is a biodenifo activated sludge plant, and in brief, a biodenifo design gives a very flexible operation which is easy to operate by online control. There is biological nitrogen and phosphorus removal at the plant, and phosphorus is also removed chemical. The plant consists of two separate lines which operates alternating, and there are several online meters at the plant, for example, ammonia, nitrate, and phosphorus, as well as a lot of online meters, suspended solid meters, and sludge blanket meters, for example. Before the implementation of STAR, there was a simple online control at Ede wastewater treatment plant. And this is a photograph of Ede wastewater treatment plant, there are two separate lines, one here and one here, with process tanks and three final settling tanks to each line. So how come that Ede wastewater treatment plant did consider an advanced process control in the beginning or at all? Well, during the last few years, Ede wastewater treatment plant has experienced an increase of the load to the plant. And furthermore, the plant could expect around 20% in future years, which meant that Ede had to consider some alternative solutions in order to gain the extra capacity of the plant. Ede had problems in complying with the EU effluent demands of a maximum of 10 milligram nitrogen per liter. So an alternative solution had to be considered in order to gain the capacity. Careful consideration was made to either an expensive extension of the plant by a third process line, or for example by an advanced process control. And the decision was made by Waterboard Vallei & M for implementation of advanced process control by STAR control. So how does STAR connect to the SCADA system? This is a typical setup of the SCADA system, which is in main control of the wastewater treatment plant. The SCADA system exchanges input and output to all the equipment by the PLCs. A huge amount of data are stored in the database, and SCADA delivers the set points to the PLC in order to activate the mechanical equipment. STAR is an add-on system for optimization of processes. And STAR connects to the SCADA system by using an OPC communication protocol. It is only a small amount of the data that STAR is receiving from the SCADA system or and the PLCs, since it's only every second minute that data is delivered from SCADA to the STAR system. Also, STAR delivers set points to the SCADA system every second minute, and the set points are forwarded by the SCADA system to the PLCs in order to activate the mechanical equipment. So only around 5% of the total amount of data are forwarded to the STAR system, and all data internal calculations are stored in STAR database. STAR can access the internet by a local area network browser for production updates and support. And only a few things has to be programmed in the SCADA system by implementation of STAR, since STAR uses the connections from existing connections from SCADA to the PLCs. So in this specific case at Ede wastewater treatment plant, the programmer only had to do a few tests on site in order to make sure that the mechanical equipment was receiving the set points from STAR. So when programming and configuration of STAR, the programmer was in Copenhagen, and the operator could follow the processes by the internet of STAR. STAR can optimize very different types of wastewater treatment plants and processes due to the software configuration, which you see an example of here. So this is the SCADA and PLC system, as I told you about, with the OPC communication protocol. And this is examples of modules in STAR. When implementation of a STAR at a wastewater treatment plant, the process engineer defines the processes, and the software engineer then program the software by using these standard modules configuration. So this is an example of, for example, aeration tank settling module for stormwater control. This is a phase module, and this is a simulation module, and this is the graphical user interface module examples of. So this could be a module of anything almost. When configuring the specific STAR at a specific plant, the modules here are plugged in the module controller bar inside the STAR software to configure the total STAR. How many and which modules to install on a specific plant depends on the situation of the client and the presence of the online meters. A small wastewater treatment plant could use only a few modules, or a large wastewater treatment plant could have a lot of modules in order to control the plant. The STAR control at Ede hosts this following modules. There is a phase, NDN phase control, an oxygen control, and a return sludge control. The phase control is indeed a control of the phases, the length of the phases, and whether the operation should be in nitrification or denitrification. The oxygen control is a control of the oxygen set point delivered to the process tanks, and in this specific case there are a lot of individual set points to the process tanks. The return sludge control is a control of the return sludge flow based on suspended solids in the return sludge flow and sludge blanket meters at the final settling tanks. It is important to notice that the STAR control is based on the data supplied by the online meters. So this is the photo again of Ede wastewater treatment plant, and here you see the relevant and most important online meters located. And these are the controls, and the picture is showing which online meters are used for which control. So for example, ammonia, nitrate and phosphate are used for both the dissolved oxygen set point control and the NDN phase length. And for return slots control, the suspended solids and the slots blanket are used. The star at ETA is set up as two individual masters, which means that we are using the online CEDAS, online sensors of each line for each master line control, which means that they can be controlled separately. So how does the star look? This is the user interface of star, which is accessed by a local area network browser or a secured internet browser. This graphical user interface holds all the important information, which is indeed all the measurements from the online sensors and the status of the system. The main page holds the most important information, and as I said, the online control of STAR is based on online sensors, which means that it's very important for STAR to have reliable data and a stable communication. But, however, STAR has the possibility of detecting if, for example, a sensor is in failure, or in respect to the process, if a signal has reached a maximum value, for example. These are the status of the online meters and the data quality, which means that STAR has an internal data quality check in order to evaluate if the data are okay for controlling. So there will be a green check mark if the data are okay and the sensors are okay, and a red cross if the data is not okay. This is the results of implementation of STAR at ETA wastewater treatment plant. And if we compare this reference period of 8 months with this operation period also of 8 months, it is obvious that there has been a significant decrease of the total average nitrogen during the operation period. This has indeed caused a huge saving on wastewater fees, which, because here at this reference period, the average total nitrogen was around 12.1 milligrams per liter, and in the operation period, this was around 6.8 milligrams per liter, which means that the total nitrogen are now below the EU effluent demand of a maximum of 10 milligrams per liter. So, the implementation of STAR has been a success due to the operator, which has been very dedicated, and the STAR technical features and also the supporting onliners. But if we have a look at the flow during the period, it is also obvious that the flow indeed has increased as expected. The load to the plant has also increased, and the total nitrogen in the effluent has dropped from around 12 to 8.4 in January. This means that the implementation of STAR indeed has been a success, because highly satisfactory results has been achieved in a very short time of 8 months. And the reduction of total nitrogen is a reality also during winter. So the plant did gain the extra plant capacity, and there's no necessity of an extension of a third process line. Yeah, so I think it's just about that.
Yeah. Yeah. Perfect. Thank you. Do we have questions? You can.
Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah.
Does STAR have any mechanism, the safeguard mechanism, to prevent it from sending non-sensible set points to the PLC.
Yeah, but I don't understand the what set point did you mention?
Does STAR have any safeguard mechanism to prevent
Yeah. In the settings of STAR, you have the possibility for typing in minimum and maximum of the set points.
Thank you. This is Rüdiger Knauf from Siemens. I think it's showing very impressively how advanced control can really benefit a wastewater treatment process. I would be interested in your case study. I think you showed the decrease of total nitrogen as a result of this control. How did the energy or the cost develop during the same period? Do you have any data on that which you can share?
Yeah, of course, that's a very important remark. But the energy consumption of the same period has not been increased. I would like to say that the energy consumption has decreased, but I think it's almost the same before and after implementation of STAR. Yeah.
Thank you. Very nice work, actually. I have two questions. One question is, you mentioned that the start control you actually implement in this completely different separate controller, and then you're using the OPC server to connect to the existing SCADA system. What is the intention? Is that because try to minimize the modification that the existing SCADA system in the plant, or it's due to the computing power is not enough in the existing plant?
Yeah, I would like to the project manager to let her answer the question.
I'm working together with Dorte on the STAR system. The OPC protocol is chosen to be able to connect to different SCADA systems. So it's just to go to a internationally approved communication protocol.
We have time for one more question.
Hi, my name's Paul. I'm just wondering, your STAR system is used to modify set points that are already existing inside the SCADA in the PLC. Would you have not have looked at maybe modifying the PLC code and the parameters of the function rather than just modifying the set points to get a more streamlined result?
Yeah, det må du gøre. Yeah. Tine again.
Yeah, actually, when introducing a superior advanced process control, of course, you're very dependent on the regulations in the PLCs. Most of the treatment plants with STAR introduced are very good in regulations. That means you can almost barely just use the set point and the controllers. Of course, you have to consider the condition of the actual PLC controllers if you need to update for basic control to PID control or whatever necessary. So you have to consider the system you work on.
Okay, thank you. With this, we would like to conclude our last session of this morning. Let's thank the speaker again, and then you're all invited for lunch.